This session we will discuss about CTFT. CTFT is a continuous time Fourier transform. Using the Fourier transform, we can plot the amplitude and phase spectrum which provide us all the information about amplitude and phase of such elementary signals. Fourier transform used for the analysis of signals, but Laplace transform used for the analysis of system. Formula of Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform. Then CTFT of xt equals to x j omega. Then formula of CTFT x j omega equals to integration minus infinite to infinite xt e raised to minus j omega t dt. Then inverse Fourier transform x j omega equals to xt. Then inverse continuous time Fourier transform xt equals to 1 upon 2 pi integration minus infinite to infinite x j omega e raised to j omega t d omega. Condition for the existence of Fourier transform. Dirichlet's conditions. The signal xt has a finite number of discontinuities and a finite number of maxima and minima in any finite interval. Second, the signal is absolutely integrable over the range minus infinite to infinite. That is, integration minus infinite to infinite modulus of xt dt less than of infinity. Example of CTFT. We consider the example of CTFT. Determine the continuous time Fourier transform of a continuous time signal given as xt equals to e raised to minus at ut a greater than 0. E raised to minus at ut is a single-sided function because the main function e raised to minus at is multiplied by unit step function ut, which exists only for t greater than equals to 0. Ut is unit step function for continuous time signals is defined by t greater than equals to 0 value will be 1, t less than 0 value will be 0. When any function is multiplied by a unit step function ut, then the resulting function will exist for positive side only. Now, definition of Fourier transform, x j omega equals to integration minus infinite to infinite x t raised to minus j omega t dt. Put the value of x t in the formula. Then x j omega equals to minus infinite to infinite e raised to minus at ut e raised to minus j omega t dt. We remove the unit step function, then limit will be 0 to infinite. Solving the integration, we obtain x j omega equals to 1 upon a plus j omega. Then CTFT of e raised to minus at equals to 1 upon j omega plus a. The Fourier transform x j omega is a complex value to plot x j omega as a function of frequency omega. We express x j omega in term of its magnitude and phase spectrum. We assume a complex number z equals to a plus iota b. Then magnitude of z equals to root a square plus b square and phi equals to tan inverse b upon a. Then we calculate magnitude of x j omega equals to 1 upon root omega square plus a square and phase equals to minus tan inverse omega upon a. We put the different value of omega. We calculate the magnitude and phase. Omega equals to 0. Value of m equals to 1 by a. Omega equals to a. Value of m equals to 1 by root 2a. Omega equals to 2a. Then value of m equals to 1 upon root 5a. then we plot the magnitude omega equals to 0, maximum value of magnitude equals to 1 by a. So we draw the magnitude plot. Figure A is a magnitude spectrum of xj omega. Similarly, we draw the phase spectrum. We put the different value of omega or calculate the value of phi. Omega equals to 0, value of phi equals to 0, omega equals to a, phi equals to minus pi by 4, value of omega equals to minus a, then value of phi equals to pi by 4. We draw the phase spectrum of xj omega in figure number B. Properties of CTFT. First one is linearity. CTFT is also a linear transformation tools which is used to transform a signal from time domain to frequency domain. Let we consider two continuous time signal x1t and x2t. Then continuous time Fourier transform of x1t equals to x1j omega and Fourier transform of xt2 equals to x2j omega. Then from linearity of CTFT, CTFT of ax1t plus bx2t equals to ax1j omega plus bx2j omega. Second property, differentiation. This is a very important property because it replaces the operation of differentiation in the time domain with that of multiplication by j omega in the frequency domain. This property of CTFT is useful for the analysis of continuous time linear time invariant system described by differential equation. So using differentiation property, we can solve the differential equation and we can calculate the frequency response and impulse response of the system. Third one, convolution property. It is stated that convolution of two functions in time domain is equivalent to their multiplication in frequency domain. We consider two continuous time signal x1t and x2t. Then Fourier transform of x1t equals to x1j omega and Fourier transform of x2t equals to x2j omega. Then CTFT of x1t convolution of x2t x1j omega into x2j omega. Thank you.